I've been thinking about your suggestion that I should pack up and move out to Los Angeles. Oh, but seriously, Laura, think about what that would mean.
What's there to think about? Get out here.
Move. I can't move. There's stuff in my refrigerator. I got a lease.
Then come for a visit. You can stay here with me. There's tons of room.
Bears Packers Sunday. South End Zone. It's non-negotiable. LA out there. Wisconsin cheeseheads in here. This doesn't work.
I've got satellite TV. It works like a charm. You wouldn't miss a thing.
I'd miss the beach.
Clyde, you've never seen the beach.
I've never seen you.
Well, then here's a picture. I'm in the back row, third from the right.
I guess this will have to do. Just driving 2,000 miles through freezing rain. I can't do that.
Guess I'm going to the beach by myself.
When Laura's first letter arrived 2 months ago, I wasn't sure what to make of it. I didn't know who she was. Hell, I'd never even heard of her. So I got on the phone. I called around and it turns out Laura's mother's father's father was my father's mother's brother. You know, second cousins, once removed. Well, maybe you didn't know, I didn't. Anyway, I don't normally go for family reunions, but last Friday, a couple of things happened that seemed too significant for me to ignore. Laura's tape showed up on my desk on the 51st floor of the Hancock, and Ed Dudorf, the account executive in the office next to me, tossed a fire axe through his window and jumped. An hour later, my boss came in and offered me Ed's job. That afternoon, I left advertising. I took the stairs. It's important to keep track of these things. Otherwise, you lose perspective. This is kind of comfy. Huh. Black cat.
On foot, still wearing that ugly-ass tie.
What's that?
Next.
What? Thanks a lot.
I don't like spiders either.
What?
Don't like any kind of bugs. Spiders, roaches, cheese, gnats. They're all part of Satan's army.
Oh, yeah?
Why? Buzzing, crawling, biting, stinging. You're like little kamikaze devils. Now this here's a promised land.
That's so.
Very few bugs in this town. Heaven on earth. That's where you're sitting, pal.
She's got into the fireplace and got covered with soot. I put her out back and now she's chasing a duck.
What?
I ain't buying anything. Clyde, come on in.
Wait a minute. Excuse me? Who are you and how do you know me?
I'm Lou. I saw your video.
What, do you live here?
Not really. I just watched the place when Laura's gone. You know, kind of house sitting for the house sitter. Keeps the owners happy. You want a taco?
Yeah. Sure.
So what's with the tie?
What?
The tie. Why are you wearing the tie?
Why do people call you Lou?
It's my name.
It's my tie.
So do you have a key?
Yeah. You know, Laura sent me one. Actually, she said she might be on location when I got here. Some kind of vampire movie.
Vampire movie, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I can see that. Hell, I'd bite that neck.
So what can you tell me about Laura?
Not much. I never see her. She's kind of a drag. But on the other hand, this place is good for my writing.
What do you mean?
And although some places they don't appear to be inspirational, they're right for you. They put you at ease.
What do you mean, like a beach?
Or this house.
This old Victorian's good for your writing?
No, the neighborhood. I write dialogue for Spanish TV.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Huh.
From the crew decided to go to Vegas last weekend. so I thought I'd tag along. I just wanted to break even. Can you believe this? It's $500,000. I haven't told anyone else except my friends Rad and Natalie. I'll be back in town tomorrow, so if you have some free time, you should meet me at Rad's apartment and we'll spend the day at the beach. I'll leave directions and one of these in my dresser for you. See ya.